you one across. You see Manava there? There you go. Now we go to the next clue that's there. So that clue was called an anagram clue. What all did it have? It had the anagram letters, which was a mark. It had an anagrind. The anagrind is a word like changed. The changed or something that says some kind of movement. It could be various things. It could say attack, it could say jump, push, various things. You will, as you do crosswords, you will find them all out. But it will always sit next to the words that need to be jumbled up. Okay? And that's called the anagrind. And there was a definition. Now we go to another clue. Confused in game puzzle. Six letters. Confused in game puzzle. So now remember these things. You're looking for an anagrind, a word that means some kind of movement. You're looking for a definition, something that tells you what the answer is going to be. You're looking for letters that need to be jumbled up. And you're looking for how many letters in the answer. There are six letters in the answer. Now, what could be the anagram? The letters, the word that says something needs to be done. Is it game? Is it confused? So now if we see there are four words, we see all the four words all are missing. Which of these is telling you some movement? Confused is telling you some movement. Confused is saying some mess is there. What are you confusing? What is next to the confused? In game. So in game is how many letters? Six letters. In has two letters. Game has four letters. So you have to confuse in game to get an answer which means puzzle, which is six letters. Okay? So the definition is puzzle. The answer has six letters. So the fodder or the letters to be jumbled up is in game. So what do you think is the answer? Has anybody got it? Other, you already got a prize, so we have to ask someone else. Very good. You already got the nuts. No one else? Confused in game puzzle. Not imagine. Imagine seven letters. Close, close. Think of a puzzle. Word for a puzzle. We give it to you?
Enigma.
Enigma. The answer is enigma. Now some of you said, oh, I didn't even know that word. What did I tell you? Every time you do a crossword, you will know a word. You will learn a new word. It will build your vocabulary. So even if you didn't know it, there you go. You will. Well done if you got it also. So confused in game puzzle is enigma. So now we see we have a lot of letters coming there and that are going to help you sort all those down clues. Let's see the next clue. The next clue says, T for artist in Meera's get together. You know who Meera is? She was here today and yesterday and she's a special guest here, author K.R. Meera. So it's not that Meera, but it's some Meera who's having a get together and it says T for artist in Meera's get together. So you see the surface in all these clues paints a story. There's a nice story going on. And then you look at the answer, it'll have nothing to do with that story. Because that story is there just for you to read and then start thinking things. But the actual cryptic clue has to be broken down to its parts. Here it says, T for artist in Meera's get together. And in this clue, you have to know certain things to be able to do it. Number one, there are some standard abbreviations that are there in all these clues. Okay? For example, artist is the letters R-A for Royal Academy, from Royal Academy of Arts. So an artist is R-A and T is the letter T. So it's telling you T for artist in Meera. So you take the letters of Meera, take the artist there. Where is the artist there? The R-A in it. And instead you put T and you will get a word that means get together. So what do you get? Meet. So there you go, that's meet is the answer. So and it's also one down, you already had M dash E dash. So meet is the answer for this. This type of clue is called a substitution clue. So in some of these clues, you will be told that you have a word, it will be given directly or it will be given as a synonym, and you will be told one letter changes with another letter, and you do that and you will get the answer for that. Let's look at the next clue. This is the hidden word clue. In hidden word clue, all the letters of the answer are there in the clue itself for you to see. Here the clue is inside solar cab service. Inside solar cab service. Inside means you look inside some word that is just next to it. So what's the word next to inside?
Side.
Solar. Okay, solar is the word next to inside. So inside solar, you have a cab service. Cab service is the definition. You look inside the letters of solar, you need a three-letter answer for a cab service. Some taxi service. Most people who go to India will know. Okay, my son wants to answer it, I'm going to let him do it. Okay, the answer is?
Ola.
Ola. Ola is the answer. Inside solar, S-O-L-A-R. If you just look at the letters of solar, you have O-L-A, Ola. Have you not heard of Ola? Uber and Ola, you all know it, right? So cab service is Ola cab service. It's inside solar. If you just read by the direct meaning inside solar cab service, you'll be thinking, what kind of solar cabs are there? Are there solar cabs now? You know? So that is the surface story. It's always meant to just trick you. You have to read the clue. The cryptic clue says, inside solar cab service. These clues are also called telescopic clues. These are the easiest in a crossword. Usually there will be two or three of them in any cryptic crossword. You just have to know how to look for them. Once you have them, then you already have an entry into the crossword. Let's see if we have another one in this. Star in Bhavan. It's much before the time of a lot of you children, but it's a Hindi movie. And that Hindi movie had the name of a movie star. That person actually debuted in that movie. That movie star debuted, made a debut in that movie. It's the name of a person you have to find inside these letters, Bhavan. So here, what is the indicator that tells you it's a hidden clue? Which word tells you it's a hidden clue? Star is the definition. Star is the definition. You're looking for a star in. So where are you looking for the star? You're looking for it inside. What? Bhavan. The word Bhavan. So what could it be? Anybody has an answer? From this side, is anyone participating from here? The answer is Reena. Reena Roy, her first movie was Bhavan. If you look at that, B-A-W-R-E-E-N-A comes together, the answer is Reena. Reserve published work. Reserve published work. This clue is called a double definition clue. Here, there are two words and there are two meanings of the same word, both are there in the clue. So you need a four-letter word that means to reserve something. You also need, that same word should also mean a published work. What would it be? Yes?
Book.
Book is right. Book is the right answer. Very well done. So you get a prize also. Please note her name. Book. So reserve published work is book. The solution to clue 18A is also a double definition word. The clue is possessed what you ate. Possessed what you ate. It's a three-letter word. A word which means possessed. It also means what you ate. Anyone who has not answered can answer. Yes? Had. Had is correct. H-A-D. I had something, I owned it. I had samosa, ate it. Right? So possessed, what you ate, is had. It's such a simple word, but sometimes we don't think, right? So this basically, when you do these kind of crosswords, you start thinking of words in more ways than one. So this is called a double definition word. These type of clues are called letter selection clues. So this is another clue type. In letter selection clue, you have to take either the first letters of all the words or last letters of all the words or something that will be told to you. If it says starts or beginning, okay, then you take the starting letter. If it says ending, finally, the last and all, you will take the last letter. You will see the words that come after this indicator. These clues are usually called letter selection clues. If they take first letters, they are called acrostic clues. Okay? So here is the clue. The clue says, starts to gaze at lady or girl. Starts to gaze at lady or girl. Now here, what is the definition?
Gaze.
No, the definition always has to be at one end. It will be either the beginning or the end.
Start.
Do you think it is start? Girl is the correct answer. Girl is the definition. Okay? And starts to is telling you, take the first letters of everything that comes after it. So what comes after it? Gaze and lady. If you take the first letters of gaze, because you are only looking for three letter answer. Gaze and lady, take the first letters, what do you have?
Gal.
Gal is a girl, right? So, starts to gaze at lady or girl, the answer is gal. The next one I want you to think and tell me the answer. It's similar clue. That's 14 down. Aptly using tails, he obtains readers primarily. Aptly using tails, he obtains readers primarily. Six letter word. Primarily tells you take all the first letters. Six letter answer. Who is going to get it first? Aptly using tails, he obtains readers primarily. Author is right. Author is right. A-U-T-H-O-R. See? And it's called an angling clue because the whole clue is also a definition. That's what authors do. They use stories and they get readers, right? So the whole clue itself works like a definition for this. Aptly using tails, he obtains readers primarily is author. Examine German car model. Examine German car model. To be able to solve this clue, you need one more hint. And that is, model is usually an abbreviation for the letter T. Okay? Model means T because after the Ford model, T car. And it's always used as crossword. Once you start doing that, you will know. So, model is letter T. This is a charade clue. The definition is on the left, which is examine. So you need a four-letter word for a German car and you put T at the end of it to get a word that means examine.
Test.
Test is not test. Five letters. And test is not a German car. Think more. German car is four-letter word. Then you add a T to it and you get a word that means examine. We have at least one person who has the answer, but he already got a prize. So let's see if anyone else. Come on, people. Think of other German cars.
Tesla.
Tesla is not start. You know, we need it to end in T, not start in T. And the answer we need is examine. A word that means examine. You only need a four-letter car.
Audit.
Audit. Audit. You know the Audi car, right? Audi plus T. is audit. And audit means examine. Let's look at the next clue. Modi ordered to welcome King, a Japanese emperor. Now, the game has gone up one notch. In this clue, it's not just one type, there are more than one type in what. I'm going to tell you how. Modi ordered. Ordered is what kind of a word?
Demand.
Yeah. It also, if you look at it in the sense of an operation as an indicator, it means to put things in order, right? What have you to put in order? Modi. So the letters M-O-D-I, you have to rearrange it or anagram it or jumble it. And what is he ordered? To welcome king and a. King is usually R or K. Okay? In this case, it's K. You have to put K and A inside an anagram of Modi to get a word for Japanese emperor. The answer is a word that means Japanese emperor. For the Japanese emperor, all of you think, you have to jumble up the letters of Modi and then inside it you have to insert K and A. Who has the answer?
No, K and A.
K and A. The answer is six letters. It has an anagram of Modi and inside it an insertion of K-A.
Kamodi?
Tomika.
Huh?
Tomika.
Not Monika.
No.
Monika has an N but no D.
No. D-O-M-I-K-A. D-O-M-I-K-A.
Yeah, it's not a very common word. It's a little bit of a tough word. Not everybody knows. Let me give you another clue. It starts with the letter M and ends with the letter O. Anybody? The answer is Mikado. 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 Okay? Mikado, Makido, pronunciation wise. But yeah, Mikado is the right answer. It means Japanese emperor. So, another word. You didn't know Enigma, you didn't know Mikado. You learned two new words here. And it means Japanese emperor. See how Modi has gone to welcome. He is always traveling, right? Our prime minister. So, he's gone to welcome a Japanese. It makes a nice story as well. But then what here, if you take the cryptic clue out of it, Modi is ordered that we jumble up the letters of Modi. Welcome means take some letters in, King and A, which is K and A, and you get Japanese emperor, which is Mikado. I'm going to give you four clues together, because now I have taught you so many different types. First type we learned was, what was the first type of clue we learned today? What was the, we learned charade and emulate. We said bird slow to imitate is emulate. That was a charade clue. What else did we learn? What was the first one across clue? One across clue was manama. What was that clue type? You had amman. And you had to jumble it, so that's an anagram clue. Then we did enigma. What type of clue was that?
Enigma.
It was also an anagram clue. So both of those were anagram clues, which had an anagram, then we had a definition, all of that. Then we saw, after that, what did we do? We did book, for example. Book was what type of clue?
Double definition.
Double definition clue, very good. Because we said, reserve a published work. We did clues like, Veena. What clue was that? Veena. Bavre Nen, star in or inside. We said that's a hidden word. And we also did. So, of this, so double definition, hidden word, charade, and anagram. So, let's take these four big types and you have to find out which one is which in these four clues. Okay? I'm going to give you four clues now and you're going to be having to identify what is what. First one is read as novel for dignitary in BKS Bookfest. Is read as novel for dignitary in BKS Bookfest. And if you see the answer has got eight letters. And what you have there? Dash A R B dash 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 I. Dash A R D dash 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 I. A dignitary in the BTS Book Fest is sitting in this queue. First of all, what kind of clue do you think it could be? Do you think it could be a double definition clue? Do you think it could be a hidden word clue? Do you think it's a charade? Do you think it's an anagram? You have no idea? How do we find out? Okay, one way to do is, how many letters are there in the answer? There are 8 letters in the answer. Is there anything in the clue itself that also adds to 8 letters? Is red as, looks like it could add up to 8 letters. We look at all the letters that are out there. We have A, R, B, I. Is it there in these? Is red as? Sardesai, see? Now we're talking. Sardesai is an anagram of is red as. And novel is also an anagram. Novel is something new. So is red as is becoming something new. And what is it becoming? It's becoming Sardesai, who's the dignitary in the BTS Book Fest. So he gets a prize also. Next clue. Fruit color. Six letters, fruit color. Do we have any letters for it? It starts with O, S and G. But you all got prizes. So, orange. Orange is correct. You all got it. Here is a word that means fruit and it also means a color. So what type of clue is it?
Double definition.
Double definition clue. There you go. Next clue. Part of the body inside the elbow. Part of the body inside the elbow. It's 4 letters starting in H.
Right.
4 letters starting in H. Yes? Huh? Hand. What kind of clue would that be? What kind of clue would that be? It has to be a cryptic clue.
What's the question number?
Part of the body, yeah? Huh? Not vowel, we only need 4 letters. And it starts in H. Where are you getting it from? It has to come from the clue. Part of the body inside the elbow. Now part of the body you all have figured is the definition. We are all looking for body parts. Well done. But what's the indicator?
Heel. Is it heel?
Huh?
Heel.
H-E-E-L. H-E-E-L is correct. Heel. How did she get heel? Inside is telling you look inside these letters. If you look inside the elbow, there is H-E-E-L, heel. So part of the body inside the elbow. Now you know, cannot think, oh my, heel is not here. Because it's a cryptic clue. It makes you think it's something else. That's why somebody thinks, oh, elbow, maybe vowel, because it's an anagram. If it had been 5 letters, very common answer for elbow, anagram is vowel. It's there in many clues. But this clue is a telescopic or a hidden word clue. You have to look inside the elbow and get healed. Well done. So she spotted the hidden word clue. And the fourth one. Take advantage of American English. Take advantage of American English. It is a 3-letter word. It starts in U. Use is correct. Use is the right answer. American is US. English is E. You put US and E together, you get use. And that's take advantage of something is to use it. Okay? So definition take advantage of. American is US. English is E. Use is take advantage of American English. Several are keenly returning to home state. Now, returning is another indicator. When you return, what do you do?
I know.
Wait. When you return, what do you do? You are going somewhere and returning means you are coming back. Okay? So here, the letters are there together, but they are coming back. Okay? Wait. Wait, children. Let the adults catch up with you. Okay? Several are keenly returning to home state. Look at that clue there. How many letters you got? It starts in K. It ends in L-A.
Kerala.
Kerala. Kerala is there. If you see the letters, several are keenly. Start from the letter K in keenly and go back. K-E-R-A-L-A is there. Okay, several are keenly returning to home state. And home state is Kerala, of course. Again, it's linked to the BTS Book Fest. Next one. Place in Bahrain where Sarah parties. Place in Bahrain where Sarah parties. What is that? Huh? Manama? So she got four letters.
Three letters, no?
Four letters. Sarah. S-A-R-A, Sarah is parting, which means jumble it up. If you jumble up Sarah and look for a place in Bahrain, you have Sar, S-A-A-R, Sar. Okay? Place in Bahrain where Sara parties, please, the Sar. Please. Next one.
Ma'am, please.
You want to know already? Wait. Leave, go be, say. Okay? Leave, go be, say. I'm not going to look at this, sir. I'm going to look for people who have not said. Now, these people have become masters already.
I did not tell.
One session, oh, you not have got a prize? Okay, this goes for you.
Dessert.
Dessert is correct. Dessert is correct. See, there you go. Didn't even take us half an hour. Already the kids know how to do it. That's the beauty of it. What all do they learn? Gobi is a dessert. You have to know some general knowledge is required. And here, what kind of clue is it? You have to now tell me what kind of clue it is. Very good. It's a double definition clue. Because to leave somebody and go is to desert that person. And Gobi is a desert, a type of desert, right? Gobi desert, Sahara desert, name of a desert. So, there are two definitions to the same answer. Leave Gobi. If you're just thinking about it, maybe you're thinking Alu Gobi or some other Gobi, you know? But really, it is Gobi desert. So, that's what it is. So, when you read the story, it seems like something. The answer could be something else. The correct answer is desert. So, you get a prize too. Fourth one.
Almost break
vehicle. Almost break vehicle. Three letter answer. And let's see what letters we have. Oh my god. Of the three letters, we already have two letters there. US. It's ending in US. And the answer is?
Bus.
No.
Sorry.
There's a little kid who wanted to answer. So.
I'm your kid.
Oh, you're also a little kid. Okay. Bus is correct. And you have to say how. How did we get that? Bus is correct because we have B-U-S. U-S is already there. How did we get the answer?
It's not an anagram.
It's not a double definition. Vehicle is the definition. It's a charade. How? Almost break. What is the word for break? Bust. Something bust, B-U-S-T, go bust, is to break it stuff for you kids, so I can understand. Almost break means you don't take all of bust, you just talk before. And if you don't leave the last letter out, you get bust, which is vehicle. So almost break vehicle is bus. This time you have one hidden word, two charades, and one anagram. Let's see which you can spot. Donkeys given direction to judge. Donkeys given direction to judge. This is a six letter answer. The second letter is S. Donkeys given direction to judge. Now what are the four directions?
East, west,
north, south. So, north, east, south, west. So, whenever it says direction, it could be N, E, W or S. So, you have a five-letter word for donkeys and then you take one direction and you add it to that and you get a word that means to judge.
I got it.
You got it. Let's see who else. Somebody new, somebody who has an answer so far. You guys got it? You children got it? No? Here, this first row is all first benches have got it. Think, something for dog is common, but you already said it. Think about it. Think a little bit more. Now, where is that? What to do with judge? To judge is to?
Examine.
Huh? Examine, yeah, but that's great. You only need six letters. What is the word for dog is? Yeah? Assess is correct. Assess plus S is assess. And to assess is to judge. Right, that's well solved. So the answer is assess. Of course, the front bench is all got in this time. Let's see another one. Insect in the pants. Three letter answer, ant in your pants. Three letter answer is ant. Yeah, yes, very good, well done. There you go. What kind of clue is that? It's a hidden clue or a telescopic clue. Next clue. Ray impacted family of six. Four letters. Ray impacted family of six. Now when you think of it, what do you think about this family?
Six
people. Six people, no? But in crosswords, they're tricky.
F-A-M-I-L.
It could be F-A-M-I-L-Y, but actually, it talks about the clue which is there in number six. What's the clue which is six?
Impacted.
No, that in your crossword, which clue is number six? It's Kerala. Kerala is in six down. So actually it's talking about family from Kerala impacted by rain.
Flood.
Not, this is the story that you're reading. But now think, we need only four letters. What would the word impacted mean? What would it be? As an indicator, it is a? What kind of indicator is impacted? It's an anagram indicator. So what do you say? Nair. Nair is right. So rain impacted family of six. So family of six means family from Kerala. The six is six down, which is Kerala. And when you have an impact rain, it means jumble it up and you get Nair. Nair is a family in Kerala, which you should all know definitely. Well done, well solved. Next one. Star going west for Jerry and Mickey, perhaps. Star going west for Jerry and Mickey, perhaps. Four letters. Four letters. And you have R dash D dash. Rats. How did you get? You have to explain the answer. Very good. Well done. What is the definition? Very good, so far so good. Now how did it get from the word play? What's the word play? How did we get rats from there? Where is rats? So star is
going west,
going in the other direction, right? This is the crossword is going from east to west. So going west, it becomes from
rats.
Just a reversal indicator. It's a reversal indicator. So if you reverse star, you get rats. Of course, like my son says, but they're not rats, they are mice. Yeah, but you know, in the crossword, we can give some flexibility. Here are the last three clues in the crossword. In the first half, Mamuka shot wild animals. Who's Mamuka?
Mamuti.
Do you all know him? Huh? So old, no? I thought maybe you all know only the latest actor. Who's the latest actor? I don't know. Yeah?
Many
other. So here, what's the answer?
Mammoths.
How did she get mammoths? From where do you get mammoths now? What's the definition?
Shark. Wild animals.
Animals is the definition. How did you get mammoths?
First half.
In the first half, Mamuka, which means take the first part of Mamuka. So M-A-M-M. And then, shot wild. So you anagram short and it makes O-T-H-S. And you get mammals, which are animals. Get bigger and get married, turning large. Get bigger and get married, turning large. I have to give you a hint for this. Married is an acronym for M. M means married in crosswords. So when you say married, it's used the letter M. So you need a three-letter word for get bigger. Then you add M to it and then you turn it around to get large. And the answer is?
Mega.
Mega. Mega. What is get bigger there?
Leg.
No. Age. You take age, you add M and you turn it around, it becomes mega. A-G-E-M becomes when it's turned mega, which means huge. And the last clue. Crazy fools left fine sitting. Again, fine is F. Crazy fools left fine sitting. Crazy is what kind of word? It's a jumbling word, anagram. It means you have to jumble up fools, F-O-O-L-S, but you have to leave fine, which means you have to leave F out and then jumble fools to get a word that means city.
Oslo.
Oslo, there you go.
Good job.
All done, Oslo. And so we come to the end of this session. We did the whole crossword up. You know, I hope you all learned a little bit how to do cryptic crosswords. If you want to do more, let me tell you about my book. I have compiled 2 books on cryptic crossword puzzles. They are there. They've been sent by people from across the globe. So we had Cryptic Crosswords Volume 2 and Volume 1. And these are all setters. There are 20 plus setters from different parts of the world, from the US, from the UK. They're all part of. I have a Facebook group called One Across. I have a blog called One Across. And every other week we run new puzzles in it. And these are all people who have put those together. First one we did, we raised money for charity against for cancer cure and research. We donated to the Area Cancer Research Institute. And both these books are available here. If you want autograph copies, I can give you autograph copies. There are also books available at the Book Fest. It's going to be there. It's available at the same price that you will get it if you order it on Amazon, but without the shipping cost. So shipping is virtually free. Okay? So these are all reviews on the book from various people. That's there. It's hardly visible here, so I'm going to skip through it. But it basically says it's a fantastic book. Yeah. Okay? Want to know more? I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you all start doing crossword puzzles because it's a lot of fun and especially for kids. And also there are some national level competitions that are happening. If you check out the site called Cryptics, there are actually clues posted every day for school children. They have for CBSE schools, they have competitions as well. So try them out, they are very good exercise for the brain. And you know, who knows, some of you might actually end up doing it for life. Right? Thank you so much. Thank you.
How to solve these cryptic clues and how to bring them up, hopefully, to follow your path. Thank you very much, everyone.